Unsere nächste Speakerin, die Christine Pietschik, die tut was, die macht was, gegen rechts zum Beispiel, die sagt gleich was.
So, und our new speaker is doing something and but is going to say something to us now, and she is a lawyer and works against the right side. She supports activists on the left side and is going to talk a bit more about what happened about the prohibition from linksunten.unitymedia.org. So listen now, and afterwards say something and do something. Thank you very much, and a great round of applause for Christine. And the same from us from the translation cabin. Here are Franz T. and
Siri.
And
ja, hallo, ich bin ja schon vorgestellt.
Hello, I was just presented and I'm not going to repeat that. Thank you very much for the opportunity to speak here for about the prohibition of linksunten.org. First of all, lawyers like to talk in a shortened version of words. I will try to say every word once, and then I will shorten it later on. So if I say BMI, it's Ministerium of the Interior, the German Federal Ministerium of the Interior. And we also will try to translate every word once and then use the abbreviation. I'm here just as one of many lawyers. One colleague is called, as this hall is called, the hall is called Adams, it's Hall A, and I want to give an technology disclaimer in advance. The talk is about the information we have till today. Facts may change. We may get more information. So if you want to listen it again, keep this in mind. And just say, hey, that's what they said in the TAZ, completely different. And furthermore, technology. I'm not technically optimized. That's something other people told me and I read. So please don't ask any technical questions and ask those questions to from people who really know about technology. Links Unten was a left liberal posting platform and it was prohibited. And something I wanted to say clearly, Links Unten was, because it doesn't exist anymore, a press media, and it was protected by the press media, by the basic law of press freedom. And that was defined by the Verfassungsgericht, by the law, by the most important court in Germany, that exists also on the internet, and that this is the case, and that everybody here should have the should be worried about the state of law, and that you should be worried about this. This is what this talk is about. There's a difference between a Verein and a Vereinigung. Vereinigung is a loose collection of people. Vereine are something that is founded and has a format. That's about, and it's written into a register. This is a known act that is perpetrated on purpose. The same happened at the CCC, where this administrative act happened in 1969, because something happened that might have changed the activities of many here significantly. The second criminal act to many important IT hacking attacks were made offense there. At this point, the German legal code was ahead of its time. The CCC had to decide now whether they wanted to become, according to 129 of the German law, to continue to either be a criminal union or a criminal group or to become a Verein. And the CCC decided the latter. But not every organization or every Verein has this option to become a Verein, because there are few ways to go against a Vereinigung. If there are more than two people who want to do the same thing, and that can only can also happen without an expressed discussion what they are going to do, just to work together, and they are, and in that situation, the Vereinsgesetz can be used for those unincorporated organizations. With these rules, the Verein was disbanded because it was trying to work against the laws, and by that the Verein was disbanded. This was the first disbursement of a Verein that was not incorporated, that happened so far. In this talk we are going to talk about three points: which parts of government were used, which methods were used, what was Links Unten, what is Indie Media, what is the content, what is the publicum. And finally, was it the first time that somebody did something against left press, and what is being done today? This is a BMW.
Ah, you get this video.
You know the video.
Warum dieses Bild?
Why this image? This image could be a Mercedes as well. Or a Porsche. This image is a symbol for the situation we had in the summer of 2017. There is emotion, and there has to be emotion if people look at this in one or the other direction. And in the summer of 2017, the situation was very important. If you think about putting the seizure of Indie Media Links Unten into context, there was militant protests. The police couldn't keep up with it, with the G20 summit in Hamburg. The police controlled people who lived there weeks before, searched for everything. People were controlled a lot, but these same people who lived there could not be like defended in a way that was made them feel safe. And there was massive violence by police. I was with a prisoners collection, and there were almost nobody who wasn't like hurt or had like broken bones. And there is election time at the end of September. The CDU, the conservatives, are afraid of the AfD, the right-wing populists, who are talking about their own core topic of inner security. And the BMI, the Ministry of the Interior, seizes Links Unten, which gets done by LKA Baden-Württemberg 25 August by the police. And at the same day, Links Unten goes offline with a press conference. When the Minister of the Interior talked about it, he said there were problems to shut down the homepage. Which authorities were involved with the ban? Sorry, I have to drink a bit. Firstly, the Ministry of the Interior, of course, it's banning the Verein. It's a repression that's an administrative legislation, but there can be searches and stuff, but it doesn't really fit into the really dry administrative law. If you look at the ban, you see that the Ministry of the Interior saw the problem that Links Unten was a press medium, but 1.5 pages are enough for them to just say, well, left Links Unten is so bad, they can't really be included in freedom of press. But more important, it would have been to use the telemedia law, like some posts there may have been criminal or something, and take these down. And they didn't took this way. No Minister of the Interior will stand in front of a camera and say, hello, we deleted 300 posts on Links Unten, now celebrate us. And have some police searches and stuff is much more efficient. And we are putting this for the Constitutional Court, and everyone has to do it for themselves. Why before the Constitutional Court? Because authority of the federal authority has done this. And it's a bit boring if lawyers are saying this, but please calculate that every one of these five cases will cost 750 euros just to bring it before the court, times five. So we now have to pay 3,700 euro. The postage gets claimed. We know this since recently because we only were informed after the fact, but we kind of thought about it. With every respect for the postal service, I don't think that a letter from my client to me wouldn't need two weeks to deliver. We are also putting in cases in front of the administrative court. It's not the Constitutional Court, sorry.
Auch diese Klagen kosten Geld.
Oh, this is costing money as well. Emails got seized, meaning
man tritt an den Provider heran.
The provider gets asked with like a notice by the court, and we don't get told about it. And all the contents of the mail box and everything that's attached to them gets directed to the authorities. We know from big providers that got this notice. They could have put a case against it. None of those did. And we are putting down cases in front of several administrative courts, and this will cost 350 euro. For every case. Still calculating, we're at over 20,000 euro. It's just court costs. The Landeskriminalamt Baden-Württemberg, Police Baden-Württemberg, did searches. The way they did these, we're again having cases. It's very costly again. And the money of
they are also seizing money of the event of the Verein at different groups, and each has to be sued against. They collect assumed money owned by the Verein. That's really an event that happens to the people. They take notebooks, photos, laptops, mobile phones, servers, everything. We have like 80,000 euros of material seized by the persons. And we also sue against this. And it again costs like 350 euros per case. What does the local police, it takes more data. We do not assume that the completely encrypted IT technology is broken in any ways, but that might change at some point in the future. We do not assume so, but who knows? Furthermore, they look at the post and the email. Every email is read, every letter is read, everything is read. The entry, the break-in into the interior sphere of all the people is astonishing. Another police department surveilled links unten. What does that mean for an internal secret service? They read everything and printed it, and they also collected information about those persons. We know that because we tried to get it to get the information, and we are also suing to get the remainder of the information. Furthermore, G10 information are collected. It's a special thing in Germany where phone surveillance, post surveillance, but also internet surveillance is all among these G10 rules. There were observations, so proper spying, and all of that, they decided that it is it was selected, and they say that it's according to Secret Service information, it is apparent that they could also say we think we want to say, but in the end they say we know that we will prohibit links unten, and something that whoever also mustn't miss is the Federal Internal Secret Service. They take the information from the local, they make their own surveillance, so they read and print it, and they have someone internal. And who is a spy in the person, in the group of person. So a person that responds to questions about links unten. And we know that because we can read footnotes. So that's something they all go into a report, but they also take the sticker and the photos and the newspapers and the notebooks and will present that to the Ministerium of the Interior to talk about what they really want to say about links unten. If you want to read something from a leaflet or from stickers, that's going to be quite interesting. They work close together with the Landeskriminalamt, the local police, because they will try to look at the technical proofs. If they can't find it, they will probably ask the federal police to try to decrypt it. Usually that's what happens, and usually the federal police will say, well, come again in 10 years. There are quite a few different methods of oppression, and they are used against links unten, but there's one that worked with links unten. Number one, one of the persons was 2005 on the CCC Congress in Berlin and used the SIM card in an event that was able to read the information. Here you can see a Wireshark screenshot. She makes it clear that she does not really understand it, but that's something she read about. So thank you very much for those people who tries to explain this to me and then look at my expressionless face. So here we can see this Wireshark screenshot, and here there are SMSs that were sent to this information, and these silent SMS are used by the police to locate this person. So 2011, 6 years ago, this person was interesting for some security agency. Furthermore, KTS, that is a link left house that was open for left political organizations, and a video camera was installed or seen in a 300 meters a video camera was seen in a house that was 300 meters away, and this photo was taken with a telephotographic camera and a long-term operation. An assumed listening device. Two people talked about long travel to the sun. In the reality, it was a travel to a cafe in France, but on the way back they noticed an opened interior part of the car, and we assume that there was the installation or the attempted installation or the removal of an tracker inside the car, because it was not apparently broken in and there is no data missing. An interesting information, the BKA works like Antifa, which is a left-wing organization, and they called a boss somewhere and called him, "Hey, you Nazi, here's the Antifa, we out you today, and we have sent you the outing as private message." What happens? Shortly after, GSG9 raids Tiaz with an open car, where he sat in front of a computer that was unlocked at the time and unencrypted. At the same time, links unten, as far as we know, Tiazi was assumed to have a criminal, was created a criminal activity. There are few cases against with this law, but because there are really, but it's really interesting for the police to use these, because it's a long time and they can do a lot about these laws. They looked at clearly at the computer. In the first tab, the personal information of the BKA was opened. The second tab is uninteresting. The third tab is an article in links unten, which a screenshot posted by Grinsekatze, where an internal information from the internal network of the Nazi Forum, where he thinks about protection measures from the forum. Well, great idea. What do we know about this? Because links unten published it in 2014. They looked at this repression method and published about it. Links unten, press medium, is already by now is missed already. This method shows participants of a klima camp, and on this transparent says here it says our opinion. Let's look at the history of links unten, and we'll see why it's a press organization.
The history of Indymedia, not of links unten, but Indymedia, begins 1999 with news of the protests on the BTO conference in Seattle. The photo shows the police against it for the first time. Open posting thought was used to write news from first hand in the news in first position. Nowadays we have Twitter and Periscope. In this time we hadn't. This was 8 years after the World Wide Web, so this was pretty new. Not everyone had this technical possibility to share things online, who also wanted to say something. And the Independent Media Central Seattle was a revolution because everyone could look at this. Indie Media is a do-it-yourself network that's always through with police violence, with the contents and against the activists. The photo shows Brad Will of EMC New York, who got killed by police when casting about a protest in Mexico. The basic principles, all the EMCs are different politically and technically. In 2008, Indie Media is already 10 years old. There's not much dynamics and just a lot of different opinions. If you read about it, you can see that. And the short renaissance by the G8 summit in Heiligenhafen didn't stop that. There are new media, blogs are established, and all the open posting thought is shared by those as well. 2009, when mobilizing for the NATO against the NATO Gipfel in Strasbourg, Links Unten goes online after 1 year of discussion. Odd thoughts we have, they are not internal. These are all self-published thoughts of Links Unten. You could, if it still existed, read. And they posted them themselves and made their doings transparent. Other EMCs don't, but they gave themselves an anarchistic program, basic problem, but they say they are not like dogmatic in one streaming. This is still the do-it-yourself principle, from the techniques till the left-wing radical hosting. Everything was put to anonymity, and Links Unten is writing, we don't really want to know who is writing all the terror attack threats. And the Ministry of the Interior is saying this is like a clear indication of wrongdoings. But what could you read at Links Unten? If you read this, you just think there was hatred against the police and the state and manuals for building bombs. But when the CDU asked a Landesregierung, a state government, in 2017, the government says that this homepage would give the user, including the violent left, the possibility to mobilize and share news about it. And that's after the ban, so that's not the same as what the police said. So what we have here, this report from 2015, like the funeral of a Hammerskin, a neo-Nazi, who are in the right-wing rock scene active, and his outing as a fee person, as a spy of the Verfassungsschutz. Mobilizations like against the militancy, like people writing about what things they attacked, like the train station 2011. So yeah, these happened, but other news media also share these. Theory and discussion, 2017, a lot of discussion with the G20 summit, and leaks, 2011, the internal archive of the Deutsche Burschenschaft, a right-wing organization, student organization, with every medium or press organization. You may ask, who's the audience? It's an online press, so most people will just look at it via search machines and get there. But it's, we could say that most of the people going there would be the leftists. And posts from Links Unten are pretty clear about it. 2016, we can quote it. In the media, Links Unten became the most important left-wing radical website in Germany. They are visited by thousands of left-wing people.
Oder auch hier nochmal 2010.
And here again in 2010. The most primary messages isn't what this was. It was of course that all other press press organizations become reader of links unten. For example, several large German newspapers talk about what they published. The MDR about the leak of the RFID, the chats of the right-wing party that should teach everybody what the AfD is thinking about this right-wing part, new right-wing party in Germany. And more large European, large German posts talk about that. And the third, but not completely unimportant group who consumes Unity Links Unten are the police and the authorities. And we can ask ourselves a few questions. Who is Missing Links Unten the most? Which of this? Oh, the German police. The leader said, we hope that they will ask for a lot of money. We used to surveil people to get all the information we used to get over links unten dot in the media from the internet and at really low costs. So, who misses links unten the most?
In Sachsen.
Oh, in Sachsen, where there's quite a few right-wing organizations. Most reports are there. Bremen did not scan it there appropriately. And who can't lie that strongly anymore? This Innenminister of Saxonian, who he told the press some information about who was responsible for an attempted attack, but later on it turned out that he wasn't. In Thüringen, they still mentioned that, but it should be corrected now. Links Unten is not the first repression against left media. This part of this really interesting history is, I will have to cut this short because of the time, because we want to have some time for questions and answers at the end. The Radikal was a links radical newspaper from till 2002 with different redaction that discussed many different parts, which was basically links unten but printed. The story of the Radikal is always a story of repression. The first case is that the police works against the press freedom, and a lot of the police surveillance actions and police searches, and then they are surveilled for 2 years in the 90s. Hosters are turned off, they are searched in the Netherlands, and what nobody dared to do back then, because everybody had something to you can look into, was to prohibit this newspaper. The authors of the Radikal was never called a Verein and was never prohibited or never banned, but they were still oppressed. So let's come to nowadays, where the people who are banned have the following problem. All technological devices especially all IT devices were taken away. The toaster was left behind. What that means today, if you don't have a mobile phone anymore, no computer anymore, everybody can assume like that. Money was taken by the police. Furthermore, the knowledge about a nearly all-encompassing surveillance that reduces the personal freedom because you have to think about whether a letter arrives or whether you can just talk about the telephone with your mom about family in Turner because it's going to be listened to. And every person has to sue to get this freedom back and in front of the courts. And that's not only costing a lot of nerves and power, but also a lot of money. I just told you roughly about the court costs. And but there's also travel costs to the all the costs of that are also associated with that. So far, we do not know any criminal case, but the repression against the Radikal show that it is possible that a criminal case might come forward. That is not only bad for the persons, but also very expensive. And one thing I really want to say is that the prohibition of Linksunten is a precedent. Those who run a platform that is clearly a press organization is defined as a Verein because the Verfassungsschutz, the Internal Secret Service, just decides so without proofs, and then the worst methods is chosen, even despite there being a better, less harsh method. That can only be done because of political decisions. I'm working against a victim of a mord people who announced a mord on Facebook, and Facebook wasn't attacked for hosting this information. If the Bundesministerium des Inneren, so the Interior Minister in Germany, to go with one and a half page declaration why Linksunten is so bad, every block and every other unlike media can be harmed by that, and Linksunten could only be the beginning, and that could extend the fines because it's the regulation about the incorporated groups in Germany. It's very flexible, and the hurdles are really small. I personally believe that the free press is an unnecessary requirement for a working public and discussing society, even if I have to look at the right politic magazine. But still, every person here in this room should look at the happenings, but also be solidary with those few it happened to, but where a lot more, many more people were meant or were part of the intended targets. That's why we will look into the future. At the moment, the repression is working, but Linksunten is a symbol for many people here, and that's why hard times still require independent media, and the newspaper Radikal isn't there anymore, but news from first hand, and we will see what the future is going to show. But those who help the targeted people with financial donations is able to do so. Thank you very much.
Danke, liebe Christine.
Thanks, Christine. Very interesting. We have like 5 minutes for Q&A. Please take the microphones and start with microphone one, please. Thank you very much. One part you already answered by having this account number there. Do you know how much money all of this is? 20,000 for the courts, like 60,000 for lawyers, plus how much? It's 80,000 money and material damages. They needed to lead their all day, everyday life. Everyone knows we can't work without a PC or study or something. Can't really tell since we don't really have the overview right now with lawyer costs and all of this, which may cost 60,000 upwards, more than one case. And that's a very good upper middle class car that's like pulverized there.
We've got some more time for questions. So go to the microphones. Hi, it's really interesting that basically you said that the ministerium said that it's a Verein. It would be quite interesting to look at what makes it Verein, whether it is a Verein that can be prohibited. And the Konkludentes Handeln more looks like a GbR, whether there's other construction, because if we as a forum say, yes, yes, that was a Verein, we help the ministerium. Now the answer, I was misunderstood. We do not assume that it was a Verein. The point is that I tell it how the interior minister said so, to show how low the burdens are, to say, hey, you three guys over there are a Verein, and we can ban you now with this ban.
You talked a lot about freedom of press. What did the more organized press say about it, the mainstream press? Well, there was a lot of public press because the Minister of the Interior made a press conference. There were a lot of discussions in the press where they said, well, journalist groups were critical and said, this is attacking freedom of press and we can't really do this. But what I personally didn't see was the press. And I mean everyone who's working in press, journalists, editors, people who sell it, they are all endangered, or a website like that mirrored it or something. They don't say this is a big example, we can tell the mainstream that the freedom of press gets put to the side. And it's very bad with links unten. That's why I put down the burning BMW as a picture. But this could be the door opener to say, and we're going one step further every time. And I hope that the press would look at this more critically. Well, they are also talking about us, because what kind of press isn't posting like letter by a terrorist organization if they get it into the mailbox? And isn't links unten the same mailbox? Is it just because there is an editor or something that this gets less attention? And I think they are just attacking, they have to say they are attacking us as well.
Mikrofon Nummer 4, bitte.
Yeah, oh, I've got another question about they were tagged as Verein, but now the individuals have to sue. So if we work as Verein, Why can we defend it? And the answer to that is, we say there is no Verein, so the people have to sue themselves. So Vereine are still part of the Vereinsrecht. There is no no leadership of the unincorporated Verein, and they are at person at 5 a.m. in the morning and take everything. And in that situation, the individual person has to fight against that. Individual persons are fighting here if there's not a solidary connection.
Yeah, a question. How about like help with the costs? There's state help for people who can like put down the costs themselves. Do we come from Austria? Yeah, I know this. I defended an Austrian once with you, Verfanz, if doesn't have as high hurdles as we have. In Germany, you have to have not much money, so nothing on account and debts and no car, and you have to be able to be optimistic about this, and the judge says if they can be optimistic about this. Oh no, yeah, it's much easier with you, and people get lawyers much easier, so yeah, that's the question.
I wanted to say that the story begins even earlier. Who said that that they have to meet in Hamburg? That was the ingredient that led to it all boiling over. And without this decision, all of that didn't happen. And what's the question? Are you of the same opinion? The answer now? I really don't care where they meet. You can also
die Frage auch schieben.
Schieben, bis die Zeit rum ist?
Ja. Mikrofon Nummer 4, bitte.
So basically, she does not want to make a statement.
I have a question with the emails, ceasing of emails. What's the lawful modus in Germany? What can the providers do? What can they in the US? They may not be maybe allowed to publicize it. And with which providers were these? Can you say that?
Rechtlich läuft das so ab, wenn
lawfully, if emails get seized, you go as the authority to the administrative court where the provider sits and says there is like a ban of a Verein and we are looking at the reasons. That's why we want these email addresses, and the provider who get this notice, all their information that are still saved there, plus all the mails that are going in and going out with every addendum to the email. People who didn't defend against this was 1&1, 1&1, a big provider.
Did I understand it correctly that all the law cases are cannot lead to this precedent case move into a direction where people later say, hey, we cannot use this tactic, the declaration to a Verein, something we pray that don't do anymore. Do the court cases just about the individuals, or to get the staff back to the individuals, or not leading and All right. The redeclaration, you are a Verein and we don't we ignore the other laws and just destroy you. Of course, the persons who were prohibited, they fight against that, against the organizational court, where they discuss what is more important, that is, what is discussed here, or the high order of the freedom of the press. Is it reasonable what you did there? And that's something the case here in Leipzig is, and we are suing against that, and we try to ensure that the same does not happen again with other blogs and with other platforms. But like five people fight for a lot of people who could the same thing happen to.
And a question from the Signal Angel. The question is, how many cases in this area have been opened as of now? I don't really know. They're still getting added more people because we still get notices, but we are at, let's say, like 40 cases.
Yeah, yeah.
I just wanna say, that's not just me, right? How many lawyers are there? Five. Okay.
Wir machen mit Mikrofon 2 weiter.
Another thing I wanted to add is that I have the. It appears that something is done that has been attempted to be done against left alternative structures, where the government finds an unhierarchical structure, where there are no leaders, where there's no incorporated structure, but there are a lot of people who you can't work against a few hundred people who published something on indie media, but so only those who run the indie media or a different example after the G20 protests in Hamburg, where a person was sued for bodily harm, but there's no proof that they did anything of that. They were only part of this demonstration, out of which these deeds have happened. I understand you're angry, but where is the question?
Is this okay for dich?
Okay, so now the answer. What you describe is the Ronnenberg situation in Hamburg, where a demonstration where the police decided they were attacked with stones, and on the video there are a few stones and firecrackers that don't come close to the police. A lot of people were hurt or sued afterwards. Yes, I want to say, and that's something you also wanted to say, the attacks are coming closer, and people attack with much more force and with a lot larger numbers and more massively against left demonstrants and left media, and that is something that is a political climate that has established itself, and we also have a turn to the right in the society, so maybe it's just en vogue at the moment. That does not mean that we just shut up about it. So, do what, or just do something, the motto of the conference.
Hello. Thanks for the talk and your engagement. Thanks. My question is connecting to the anger before me. The question is for the relationship between anonymity of the posts and these five defendants. How can these five be responsible for everything, every anonymous post on that website? And on the other hand, was the anonymity of the publications a problem which made this declared as a Verein and not a thing against individuals. I would take your question, answer the question with yes. Well, yeah, the public, they wanted to go after the authors of the individual posts. They couldn't, so they went after the publishers because of the anonymity. And I didn't know how to go at it another way. It's not like just an antagonistic attack. We are still before the administrative court, not the criminal court, hopefully. And we think that this ban is not just wrong because they used the wrong law to go after us, but also you want to go after someone because of suspicions and we don't have anything more. And put through a ban because of that, because of opinions of the Interior Secret Service. We don't have more. What the judge says, we can't really say, but we just can just say that the abstract democratic price we all have to pay if this happens is high. Thanks.
Wir nehmen nochmal die Nummer 4 und haben noch Platz für zwei weitere.
Four. I have the question of the left. I need a donation proof. Where can I get it to get the tax back? Is there some way to get it? Well, the account is from the Rote Hilfe, which is an organization that funds legal challenges for left situations. So write them a letter and it should work out and you should be able to get it.
Eine Bahnsteigkarte, ja. Okay. Nummer 1, bitte.
Number 1, please. Hi. You explained this very good. Why you're fighting against how this thing? If I was involved, I would fight against it because they went to me. Like, tell me, that's actually my thing. So, are you going this way? So there would be the technical question. If I did that, I would maybe think, oh, this may happen to me, so I would, like, work this way. I think I answered the first part of the question. We don't think this should happen on these little suspicions. The second question is, sorry, I really can't tell you. I'm just the lawyer.
Okay, wir machen noch die Nummer 5. Ich glaube, den habe ich übersehen.
Ja, von mir auch. Auch von mir vielen Dank für den Vortrag. Und ich würde gerne wissen, ob es noch andere Mittel und whether there are, I want to know whether there are other ways to help those attacked. Well, to create a critical society where they get the feeling that they're not alone there in any way, and if that's transparent from your window, that can help a lot.
Okay, nochmal ein riesen Applaus.
So, a great round for applause for the speaker, and we also say goodbye from the translation booth. We were Franz T. and
Sirin Sang.
Please send feedback to @C3Lingo or with the hashtag C3T on Twitter.